Hello friends, welcome on this video tutorial. Daniel is here from Tips to Fix, and in this video tutorial today I will show you how to switch from your standard SSD drive to M2 NVMe drive on your workstation. If your computer is running slow and you are not satisfied that much with your computer, then you want to put the computer on the next generation speed, then you have to replace your standard SSD drive to NVMe M2 drive. So what I'm going to do today, I will replace this SSD drive. I will clone your system C drive. That is everything, every software that you have, every program in your computer is here on your SSD drive. And then I will clone it. I will bring it here on M2 drive. And then we will compare the speed, okay? And then you will see how faster your computer will be. So if you see my computer, I have my workstation here. It's almost full for the moment. My computer in the board does not support NVMe drive directly on the motherboard, but we can use an adapter. So I have an adapter here, is PCI Express 3.0 or 4th generation. It has both and is PCI Express adapter. I will bring NVMe here on the adapter and I will put it on my computer, and then I will clone everything for free. So the software that I will use today, it's free. You don't have to pay any money, okay? Your standard SSD drive will copy files with 300, 400 or 600, okay, megabit on seconds, but NVMe M2 SSD drive will copy files more than 3 gigabytes for seconds. It's big difference on the speed on your computer. Continue watching this video. Let's go directly to the point and let's bring your computer on the next speed generation, okay? So first of all, I'm going to show you the difference on M2 NVMe drive and SSD drive. So let's see here with proof how much faster the NVMe M2 drive is instead of standard SSD, okay? So I have both in my computer, okay? If you see here, my C drive is almost full, and one of the reasons that I will have to change it is that I need to put more space here, and I have to switch from 500 SSD gigabyte drive to 1 terabyte M2 drive, okay? And I have here a standard SSD drive. This one is a really good SSD drive that I have here. H drive is a Patriot and is 1 terabyte, but let's see the standard SSD drive. Let's test it. It's here, H drive, and we have, okay, you see it's 500 megabyte in a second. So the writing speed is 450 megabyte in second, okay? Now I'm going to replace my standard SSD drive with this M2 SSD drive right now, okay? So first of all, we have to prepare it because my motherboard does not support directly M2 drive, okay? I have to use this PCIe adapter and will prepare it and make it ready. See the link on the description what I got here. I have here Crucial 1 terabyte M2 SSD drive with a PCI Express NVMe, okay? If you don't have the connector with this on your motherboard for this NVMe drive, then what we gotta do, we have to use this PCI Express NVMe adapter, and we will put this on the computer and configure it for you guys. So you can easily buy this, just click the link on the description and you will see on Amazon. It's not expensive, just buy one and use it for your computer. Open up this Crucial NVMe M2 SSD drive, okay? And here it is, my Crucial NVMe drive. We have manual here. This one is original, I mean, yeah. Crucial is not the best, but it's really good company. It's really good compared to the price. Look at this, NVMe drive is P3 Plus, okay? And it's really professional one. And let's see, it's PCI Express 4.0 M2, okay? Let's connect it here. Okay, I have here a little screw because we need this. Don't lose that. Yes, we have the screwdriver, this small screwdriver. Yeah, we have all the tools here inside. Okay, let's open up iFixit here. I have iFixit tool, and let's find, and I have to choose this one, 000. If you like this screwdriver, it's iFixit and it's really professional one. I will paste the link in the description. If you like it, you can buy directly. These ones are really professional. You can open up Mac and everything with those. Bring and connect this NVMe drive, NVMe SSD here. Okay,
and I will put the screw here. You can use the one that is here on the box, but I will use this bigger one. Okay, you don't need to tie that much. It's okay. Here it is. And I will put this here. We will clone from normal SSD drive in the computer. I will clone the system, I will clone the C drive, and then bring it here, okay? So now this is ready to put it on the computer.
So when you open up the case of your computer, you will see here the graphic card. Graphic card is using PCI Express, but you will see you will have another one in the board. This one is bigger PCI Express, and the other one here is this one here, PCI Express, and you will see the small one, PCI Express also, but is smaller. In my case, this is my adapter. This it will work also on the first one and the second one, okay? I will remove these clips. I just bring it here, and then don't forget to clip the clips. Here it is. I have here Patriot SSD drive, system drive, and also I put NVMe drive.
So in most cases, this new device will support it automatically. Then you don't need to do any change on the BIOS. Right click on this PC and go to manage. Then you will see that this new drive that I put it here on my computer, it will be listed here on device manager. If you go here on disk management, then you will see the new drive. I have here two partition. I see that is 500 and 500. If I go here on properties, and then I will see that this disk is crucial, okay? And this one is disk 5 here. It's healthy. What if your computer do not recognize your device? So what we gotta do? Let's restart the computer and we will go in BIOS to show you how to set up, okay? During the restart, we have to enter on BIOS. In my case, I have to click this escape button. In some computers will be F2 or F10. Search on Google how to enter in BIOS based on your computer model, okay? Then you will see this entering on startup menu. Click BIOS setup here. And then here on my advanced tab, I have to go here on slot settings. And here on the slot settings, you will see all the slot PCI Express that I have in my computer. I will go here on slot 5 because this is what I'm using. Slot 5 PCI Express X16. If it's disabled, you have to enable it. Make sure that you enable this, because if you let it disable, then you will not be able to see M2 NVMe drive on the Windows, okay? So enable it. And then F10 or save changes, and then click yes. Restart the computer. Okay, here we are. Here we are again. Okay, after we restart the computer and everything is set up now, we are ready to do the cloning process and switch from SSD to M2 drive, okay? I have to download the software. The free software that we need for this case is BalenaEtcher. Search on Google and go on the official website, and here it is. BalenaEtcher is the one that it will help us in this case. It's free, we don't have to pay any money for that. Just go here on BalenaEtcher and download the Etcher, and then here it is. In my case, I need this 64-bit. First one, just download it. We have to install, or we have to just run the setup. BalenaEtcher, here it is, open up. So in my opinion, this is really good software. It's free. We have to clone the standard SSD drive, C drive, on M2 drive. Okay, just clone drive here. And then what I gotta do? So what we have to clone? So I have to clone here C drive, this one. Is the source. Make sure it's source drive, okay? You have to see this message here, source, because you can make your computer empty, okay? You don't have to do any mistake. Just choose source is this one, C drive, because I'm changing the C drive, okay? And then go click select one, and then select target. I like target to be this one here, 1 terabyte, M2 drive. Select your system drive is dangerous and will erase your drive and everything as a destination, okay? I know that it's my M2 drive because is this one crucial, 1 terabyte. You see that? It's P3P, so I know what it is. And then click select. click flash button here. I'm going to click here. Yes, I'm sure. And let's see if this process will start working. This is very important because it needs administrator privileges. You have to right click and start this BalenaEtcher with run as administrator. Okay, so I'm running as administrator and I'm cloning the drive, okay, from this one to this one, okay, from the first one to the second one. And you see the process is, it's cloning the drives between each other. After this process is done, what I'm going to do is I'm going to replace and remove SSD drive and run with this M2 NVMe SSD drive, okay? So let's wait a little and then let's come back. After this process is done, you know, we'll see this message, flash completed. Turn off your computer right now, remove the SSD drive and then start the computer again, okay? And we will boot the computer from M2 NVMe 1TB, okay? And let's see how it will perform, okay? So we replace SSD with M2, okay, on the C drive. If you see the capacity, it's almost the same. So let's check disk speed now with this, go to C drive. And then let's check, look at this guys, now 3.3 gigabytes in second, okay? So you remember it was 500 read, now is 3.3 gigabyte on read. So it's really faster than before. Your computer will perform extremely faster using M2 instead of using standard SSD drive, okay? When you wanted to replace your standard CCD with NVMe, I suggest you have the same capacity, okay? And the moment when you do the clone process, the new disk will be exactly the same size, even if it's bigger. I mean, in my case, it's 1 tera, but you will see here, it will be the same capacity, 500 gigabytes, the same that it was before. If you want to use the full capacity of the new drive that you did cloning process, you have to extend it and use it, okay? Then you will have to deal with the partition management here. If you go to manage again, go to disk management. If you see carefully here on my disk, look, I have 500 gigabytes unallocated. So I need this to use and I will create new simple volume. I just click. Now you will see here new hard drive that I have here, and you can use this as a storage, okay? But if you don't like to use it as a storage, what you gotta do, you can delete this volume, extend the spaces together. But this is another video tutorial.
Thank you guys for watching this video tutorial. Let me know if your computer is performing extremely fast after you change the SSD drive. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and share the video with your friends, okay? God bless you, see you on the next video tutorial.